In a stunning backflip, the Allan government has axed plans for a second safe injecting room, claiming it couldn't find a suitable site.
The decision, spearheaded by the Premier, was made despite the Ken Lay report finding a trial in the CBD would save lives. Reid Butler begins our coverage.
Finally, a decision, and it's loud and clear from the Premier.
This now puts a line under a second injecting facility here in Victoria.
This is a captain's call, and it doesn't speak of leadership, it speaks of backing down.
The government first announced a second injecting site for Melbourne in 2020.
It will save lives. I'm convinced of that.
But fast forward 4 years, there's a new Premier and a different approach.
This is incredibly challenging and it's disappointing.
Scrapped despite the long-awaited Ken Lay report recommending a trial for a small supervised injecting room in the CBD.
We have been unable to find a location that strikes the right balance.
It's a war many city traders like Mark O'Reilly from the Elephant and Wheelbarrow have been fighting for years, today celebrating their win.
The last thing we want is have an environment like that in the streets.
It's a good outcome for business, it's a good outcome for tourists.
But it's a bad outcome for addicts, according to health advocates.
It will cost lives. I mean, there's absolutely no question it will cost lives.
Instead of an injection room, the government's focus will be on helping users beat addiction. The $95 million reforms include additional support services at the Salvos on Bourke Street and a new health hub opposite Flinders Street Station. There'll be better access to treatments, including pharmacotherapy, as well as the overdose reversal medicine naloxone.
Co-Health will start scaling up their outreach teams immediately.
An overdose prevention hotline will be established and the government will appoint its first chief addiction advisor.
We are deeply encouraged by the Allan government's commitments around a number of levels.
While this is certainly the biggest call yet from Premier Jacinta Allan, it's just the latest in a string of recent decisions which appear at odds with the socially progressive Labor agenda that voters have come to expect.
We could have pushed on and could have tried to find a site and taken even more years ahead, or we could have taken action now. And we've chosen to take action now.
Whilst we would say that the government's backflip finally on a drug injecting room for the CBD is the right decision, it follows years of wrong decisions.
Regardless, it's a decision that will prove defining for the Premier.
These are new and important initiatives that are going to save lives and reduce drug harm.
And Reid joins us now live from Flinders Street, a probable site for the injecting room. Reid, what's going to happen there now?
Alicia, this is the building that will eventually become that community health hub, but it won't be opening its doors until 2026. So by that time, it would have been 3 years since the government first received the Ken Lay report, which happened in May last year. Most of those other changes will begin being implemented from July this year. You can expect those reforms to evolve along with any other changes, adapt to the current situation. One thing that won't change, though, is this rejection of the second safe injecting site that is well and truly off the table.